Good day, inline skaters. My name is James Mackey, and I like to skate. The location I'm at right now is in Middlesboro, Tennessee. This is at the LMU campus. But I am not from here. I am actually from Houston, Texas, and that's where I live. Right now, I'm just on vacation because we are seeing my grandmother, which lives in Speedwell, Tennessee. So I hope you enjoy the video. I am by no means an expert skater. I'm actually a beginner. Just within the last 6 months, I decided to pick up this new hobby. When I was a kid, I used to skate. As you can see, I'm grinding my wheels pretty bad right now, trying to make it down this hill. But I am learning, so a good way I found to stop pretty easy would be to roll through some grass if you don't know how to skate too well. I do practice the T-stop, and that's, I try to alternate my skates out so I won't grind all the wheels down on one side. Some people may tell me I'm a little obsessed with skating, but I think it's the same as jogging or speed walking or anything else. It's actually quite fun. It's a faster pace. It's not as slow paced as jogging, so I really enjoy it a lot. It takes a lot of skill. I like the scenery. I like taking tight turns. And I like exploring new areas. So it's pretty fun to me. I try to respect properties for the most part. Any place that says no skating or no rollerblading, I try to keep that in mind and I try to respect it to the best of my ability. Downhills have been pretty fun for me. Before skating downhills, I recommend practicing how to stop first. The scenery in Tennessee is real beautiful. It's a lot of mountains. The only difference between skating in a park and skating in a city is because there's just more stuff in the city to look around, and there's more scenery. Skating right on the edge. It's fun skating downhill, but as soon as you go up one, you're gonna be out of breath. It's typically easier to skate in Houston because in Houston's more flat. I want to learn how to go upstairs better, and also how to skate down the stairs. I don't know how to do that yet, but I've seen many people do it. My body weight is 194 pounds. I am 5'7". I am pretty exhausted going up this hill right now. The skates that I'm wearing are Rollerblade Tempest 90 Inline skates. And so far, they've been pretty durable. They have 90 millimeter wheels. I've rotated these wheels about 10 times already. The wheels are finally starting to wear down. The way you can tell is whenever your feet start vibrating more, your feet start going numb, is probably time to start looking into buying some new wheels. But I'm going to wear these down until they can't go no more. The last pair of skates I had on, I wore them down so bad that chunks of rubber started to fly from the wheels. My wife thinks my socks are pretty goofy. I never really noticed. Maybe I'm old fashioned. Maybe I should start lowering down my socks. Now that I look at it, it does look kind of goofy. These skates have treated me good though. I got them from skates.com and I got them for $200. They were on sale. The original price was $360. I got the next size up because they are out of stock on my size. But they fit pretty comfortably. I don't have any problem with them. I have to wear thin socks though. I can't wear any thick cotton socks. I'll get blisters. Pick up some speed here. Advantages of skating in Tennessee: the temperature is better, the hills are steeper to go down, the scenery is better. Disadvantages: the air is thinner. That's about it. In Houston, the advantages is everything is pretty flat. More people around. The air is thicker in Houston. That's the disadvantages. Not to mention the humidity in Houston. Really takes all the energy out of you whenever you're trying to skate. In Houston, sometimes I won't last longer than 20 minutes. If I'm skating at 3 o'clock in the evening. Yeah, that hill looks pretty steep. Need to figure out how to get down this one safely. Don't want to hurt myself. Gotta summon up the courage. I don't want to grind the mess out of my wheels. They're not cheap. Take a couple of deep breaths and I'm off. This is my first steep hill, kind of a test hill for me, you know, just trying to ease my way down. Doing pretty good so far, not going too fast. I need to alternate my skates more often when I stop. If you don't alternate your skates whenever you stop, you're going to wear down your wheels excessively on one skate. Finally, sidewalk. Ooh, baseball. Free baseball, anyone? Music, please.
worry, we're all flown on. We're
all right.
All flown on.
This road is a little rougher.
Got to find
solid track. Oh look, there's people.
There we go. That's much smoother.
Pretty steep hill behind me. I don't think I'll be rolling down that one anytime soon. Now, this is the track that is actually designed for bikers and rollerbladers, skaters, inline skaters, whatever you call it. Nice and smooth. Feels like you can roll on this track forever. Not to mention, right now it is 9:30 and the sun is still out here in Tennessee. It doesn't start to get dark until about 9:45, 10 o'clock. It's about an hour difference from Houston. The hour is 9:30 right now, but in Houston it would be 8:30. Got to find out where this track leads. When inline skating, you always want to look a good 20 feet in front of you in case you roll over something that you're going to regret rolling over, such as a branch, rock, a crack in the street. And you hit one of those and you're heading for a face plant. So it's good to look ahead of you, see what's in front of you. Oh, what's this? Is this a skate park? Skate parks cannot contain me. Much too small. It's like sticking a inline skater in a cage. I can't do any tricks. I can just watch them do their tricks on their skateboards. And lack of equipment. Might be wise for him to wear a shirt. Would really hate to see him fall. Well, that's it for the skate park. Wasn't very big. Here's a nice little track to skate on. Need to get the most out of my day before the sun goes down. Experimenting with grass is pretty fun at times, depending on if it has rained or not. Try not to roll over grass that is wet, because your wheels will sink into the ground and you will fall forward. Usually when I roll over grass, it's hard dirt. Got some little hills in this track. It's always enjoyable. People do tend to stare at me sometimes because I guess they're not used to seeing inline skaters here in the United States. They see more skateboarders. That bridge was nice. It's amazing what you can roll on 8 wheels of this size with the proper energy. Have to slow down for the people. You never want to dart past anybody because you just don't know which way they're going to turn, especially kids. The kids will cost you to do several somersaults through the grass because you had to dodge them. Awesome scenery over here. Don't quite know what these little hills are for, but I'm liking them. I tried to encourage my wife to buy a bicycle so she can keep up with me. Maybe she'll be in one of my videos. Coco Productions. I don't think this parking lot connects to anything, but I have to investigate. Nope. Dead end. Nothing here, so might as well speed off. Grass is so much fun to go through. Have to avoid the slower people by changing tracks. Exiting the park now. Looks like it's time to head back and go and try to find my wife. She should be jumping her rope somewhere. Let's go on this pavement. Oh, man. Pavement's kind of rough. As you can see right here, that is rough pavement, sir. But you know me, I'm gonna go. A little too tiring for my feet. Let's go back to the nice smooth pavement. Sometimes it almost feels like you're floating if you got the right wheels, the right pavement. When I first started out, I had a 3-foot selfie stick and was kind of not satisfied with always shooting from the kneecaps down. This selfie stick that I have in my hand right now, about 5 feet, it's a lot better. 53 inches, I believe. I can barely manage to get my full body shot. Maybe I need a longer stick. I don't think I'm going to get that perfect camera angle. Well, that's not too bad. This way you can see how exhausted I am as I skate. Typically, I wear a backpack, which contains my water, contains my shoes, in case I get too tired. It's always nice to see that people like to see me skate, and they smile and wave at me, and I wave back. If you want a good exercise, this is it. No bicycling for me. This is quite the workout right here. You want to lose weight, this is how to do it. Typically, whenever I inline skate, I inline skate anywhere from 20 minutes to 2 hours a day, depending on how I feel. Today, I don't feel too bad. Like I said earlier, the air is a little bit thinner, so it kind of is harder for me to breathe over here in the mountains in Tennessee. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. That's it for me. I hope you can enjoy the rest of this musical interlude. It is called Modest Mouse Float On. Music, please.
All right. Don't you worry, we'll all float on.